going on, everyone? I got a brand new movie review for you guys today, and today we're discussing Netflix's new film, Mowgli. Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle, whatever you want to say. So this is a very interesting film that I've had my eye on for quite a while. This film was announced right at the exact time this Jungle Book came out, or around the same time they were starting to film. And, well, this one came out first, and it came out to appraisal. I really like this film. I'm a big fan of the Jungle Book, like, lore, the cartoons, the books, whatever you want to call it. I like the Jungle Book. It's one of the things I grew up with, so I really had a blast with this, and I was always looking forward to what Andy Serkis was going to do. Yes, because Andy Serkis directed this film. He's a mocap master, and we all know this, so wondering what his mocap was going to do with the Jungle Book live action was something that always intrigued me. Then it went dark. We knew it filmed, we knew it got done, but where'd the film go? Well, it turns out Warner Brothers had ended up marketing a little bit, and then they ended up just selling it to Netflix, which, again, surprising. And usually when that happens, you're like, oh, that film might not be that good. Okay, let's see where this goes. I'm actually here to say I actually quite enjoyed Mowgli. I think Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle, Mowgli, whatever you want to call it, is actually a pretty solid film. And in a lot of ways, I really like this film. I think it's a good film that's masterfully, if not greatly, directed by Andy Serkis. I think Andy Serkis is an outstanding director. As he breathed last year, he did a fantastic job directing that film. But seeing on a bigger scale and a bigger budget, this film, the way that he directs, the way that he gets all the camera angles, and the way that he is able to be a part of the mocap, because he does the mocap for Baloo, he's doing the voice of Baloo as well, and being able to direct at the same time, that's a tough thing to do, but he got every single actor to be in this and do it so well and do the mocap and do the voice, and he really stylized this film with his own stamp where it doesn't feel like any other director's stamp. It feels like a new director coming to his own, which was a big thing for me and a kind of a big worry because it very much is different than this Jungle Book. There's no singing, there's no fun, there's no bare necessities in here, no. This is a darker take on the Jungle Book. This is very much more like the original novel. And no songs, which lead to not really fun. This is kind of an adventure film. In a sense, also an epic, which I actually think it could have become an epic if it overcame a couple steps that I think it does. And this is where I kind of get to my negatives. I think the film should have been longer. Purely honest, I think the film should have been longer. There are certain elements and certain story structures where I feel like it should have gone about more. And I even go as far as to say this, I feel like this film should have been a miniseries. Like, it felt like it was book structured, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, even though it doesn't say that. And I think it should have gone more upon that. I wanted more from it. And by the end, the film just felt anticlimactic when it ended. You kind of just get your ending and you're like, oh, that's the big standoff. Okay then. Still had fun with it, but that's how we're gonna end it? Okay then. I mean, that's such a small minor gripe of mine for someone who still really enjoyed the film. The cinematography is beautiful. The CGI, at times, when it's far away, your eye kind of looks a little bit weird towards it, but when it gets up close on those animals, it is insanely amazing. Again, it's that motion capture performance that Andy Serkis is so well known for. And even when it's far back, you still see the animals. They still look good. It's not like they look horrendously bad. But the big praise for that CGI is when it's right up in their face. Like I said, with Baloo, it looked like it wasn't weird that a bear was talking. It looked real. The Bagheera, played by Christian Bale, actually, you feel it. And Bale's voice, all the voice actors in here, really, there was only one noticeable one, that was Cate Blanchett, because her voice is so distinct, but every single other voice actor really blended in, and by the end of the film, I actually had to look at the credits and be like, oh, that's who played that character, oh, that's who played that character, and I just think they all blended in so well. Each person was very casted specifically for these voice roles, and again, I think the big standout of the whole thing was either Christian Bale or Andy Serkis as Baloo, because Baloo really is one of my favorite characters in all of the Jungle Book movies, and it extends even here. I wanted more of him. I love their relationship, and I even love the relationship that he has with Bagheera. I'm probably saying these names wrong. Trust me, I'm horrible with names, but Mowgli was a pretty good surprise. Kid actor is good. Even though it's a little bit anticlimactic, I think Andy Serkis greatly directed this film, and I can't wait to see what the guy directs next. The motion capture is superb. The CGI is really good, and it has a great look and feel to it, even though the film, again, feels a little bit anticlimactic, and I think it could have been even longer or should have extended to a miniseries. I think Netflix was actually in the right to grab this, and I understand why Warner Brothers sold it to them. Again, it's not because it's a bad film. It's a good movie, But this is a hard film to market. It's not for families. I can't recommend that you take your five-year-old to go watch this or watch it on Netflix because you're having a great time. No, it's a dark movie, and it's intense at times, and a little bit scary. So if you're thinking about watching this with your kids, maybe you might want to watch it first, then take the decision up to your choice. It definitely is, like, this film was a little bit darker than I thought it was going to be, like the other Jungle Book, Jon Favreau's. But this one's also dark, so keep that in mind when you guys do watch this. I'm curious to hear your guys' thoughts on this one. I enjoyed it, so with all that said, I'm going to give Mowgli a B. Guys, let me know what your guys' thoughts are on Mowgli. What's your favorite Jungle Book version? Is it this one? Is it that one? Or is it this one? Let's talk about it down below in the comments. Again, if you guys are new here, consider hitting that like and subscribe button. Then check out Sandwich on Films also down below, because right down there you guys can get into advanced movie screens and check out some movie news and even some movie reviews. But guys, until next time, stay classy.